we've received a variety of questions from not only the teenagers in our group, but also from people outside of our group regarding prayer. And the question that we'll be tackling in this video is, how do I pray?
Mm-hmm. And we want to start answering that question by talking about where our heart should be when we pray. And we think the best summary of Scripture's teaching on that topic comes to us in the Heidelberg Catechism, question and answer 117. Here's what it says. First, we must pray from the heart to no other than the one true God, revealed to us in His Word, asking for everything God has commanded us to ask for. Second, we must fully recognize our need and misery, so that we humble ourselves in God's majestic presence. Third, we must rest on this unshakable foundation. Even though we do not deserve it, God will surely listen to our prayer because of Christ our Lord. That is what God promised us in His Word. And so the Catechism says that when we come to God in prayer, we first start off by praying from the heart, making sure that we actually desire the things that we're praying for, and that we're praying for the things that God has commanded us to pray for. And second, we come with a heart of humility, that as we enter into the presence of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, we come in our rightful position of humility. And then third, it says we come because of Jesus Christ, we come to God confident that He not only hears our prayer, but that He will answer our prayer as well.
Mm-hmm. And Jesus, when He was asked, how do I pray, or when He was teaching His disciples how to pray, He says, pray then like this. And when He says like this, He's saying just pray in this basic form. He doesn't say you have to use these words every time you pray. He just says pray with this kind of structure in mind. So He says this in Matthew chapter 6, starting at verse 9. Pray then like this. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be Your name. Your kingdom come, Your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And the church has kind of taken the format that Jesus gives His disciples here, and we've summarized it in the acronym ACTS, A-C-T-S. And what that stands for is adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and supplications. And what adoration is you are giving God praise for who He really and truly is. And confession is confessing our sins to God, acknowledging that we are sinners in need of a Savior. Thanksgiving is giving thanks to God for the things that He supplies for us. And supplications is asking God to give us what we need to live out the Christian life.
Mm-hmm. And you can take that acronym and then you can use that to guide your prayers. You don't have to necessarily always pray in that order, even though that's helpful. But you can, as you're praying, you can kind of think through, have I addressed all of those areas in my prayer? But if you're really struggling with prayer, we encourage you to pray that God would help you in your prayers, that God would give you the spirit of prayer. And then if you're struggling in your prayers, you just need to keep praying. That's really how you learn how to pray. There are some books that are helpful. This book in particular, by a guy named Ole Halsby, called Prayer, has been really helpful for me. But it's been helpful for me because he's reminded me that you don't learn to pray from a book. You learn to pray by praying and by asking God to give you the spirit of prayer. And so, pray and keep asking God to help you in that. But also don't be afraid of entering into prayer and saying the wrong things or not saying the right words. You can come to God in prayer knowing that the Spirit helps us in our prayers. In Romans 8, verse 26, Paul says, likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought. But the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And so the point is that even when we pray wrongly, the Spirit is helping shape our prayers and helping bring our prayers to God, so that even in our own weakness, the Spirit is helping us and offering our prayers up to God.